amount of rice that is within the warehouse, and now people are saying there's no rice in the country. So can you imagine? This place is filled with rice, and people saying there's no rice in the country, and they are selling rice at a high price, which is not supposed to be so. So yeah, Ministry of Commerce is trying to get to the bottom of what is going on within the country about people saying there's no rice in the country. This is the amount of rice heads within the warehouse. So,
okay, how much have you got?
So as you can see in the warehouse, the amount of rice that's within the warehouse, and the guy says some rice will be coming in a 2 weeks or 3 weeks from now, and now people are saying there's no rice, which is impossible.
Yeah. We have rice.
So everyone that is watching, people have been carrying a news around there's no rice in the country, which is not true. It's absolutely not true. Can you imagine? See the kind of rice that's within the warehouse. But people saying there's no rice. So it simply means that there's some foul play somewhere. Somebody is playing something that is not supposed to be so. So that's why the Ministry of Commerce decided to come here today to make it clear to the Liberian people that there are rice within the country. All the type of rice that have been on the market is here. So nobody should be carrying on fake news that there's no rice in the country. So the Minister of Commerce, Prof. Wilson Tappe, is here. The IG, the deputy.
You can see for yourself, you're from where?
Okay.
So you're from MCC. You can see for yourself, we have enough rice in stock.
Yeah.
That we have 5 million rice importers, and what we have right now, two of the rice importers are a little bit extremely low.
Okay.
So their customers are moving on to the remaining three who actually have enough in stock. And when they two are applying, they're applying the same customership relationship where they say, well, go to the people who you always buy from. But the firm actually told them, we have to change our strategy.
You have to serve everybody.
Yeah. Even though you may not know me, but if I came for rice today, we need you to please serve the people that are here for rice.
Okay, sir, can I ask you a question? Now people are saying there's no rice in the country, and I'm seeing a lot of rice here. So where is the problem coming from?
And I just told you, there are 5 major rice importers. All of the 5 major rice importers, each and every one of us has our own customership that we
say.
So I normally buy from you. Today you are out. I came over to contact them to buy. Contact them, tell me offer, say no, go to the gate, you always buy your restaurant. I don't want to sell you. Because when I call you to come buy from me, you tell me no. So some of these things are some of the factors that are playing out right now.
So is that the reason why the price of rice is increasing?
Any little way that we are meant for, any little loophole to steal, we'll run there. And that's just what happened to rice.
So what are the methods you guys are the Commerce Ministry trying to put in place to make sure within the next 2 to 3 weeks they get better?
After here,
okay.
Identify certain vendors,
okay.
Shopkeepers who have increased prices.
Okay.
Remove them.
So what are you guys going to do to them in place of
there's
them?
There's a law. We find increasing price that profiteering. There's a fine. And we can close you down too.
Okay.
That's what the law says.
All right.
And we will do that.
Okay.
We are only here to tell the press that we have stock.
Okay.
That can last the market. There's no need for panic, and people do not need to start doing things to profit here.
And
we'll go after them.
Okay, and basically looking at all what I'm seeing here today, I'm glad that you guys brought the press along with you to clear out the Liberian people doubts, because there are some people who've been buying rice $19, which of course isn't supposed to be like that, and basically looking at the COVID-19 situation in the country is bad. So I'm pleading with you guys, so please, if you guys happen to catch those people who are doing these things, to really, really punish them and make sure that people will be able to buy the rice at the raffle price is normally sold for. So I'm grateful that you guys are here today to welcome, and thank you for talking to us. So I saw you guys talking to the people out there, making sure to make them come. And one thing I was trying to understand is the fact that you telling them, if you used to buy 25 bag of rice and you buy 1,000, it shouldn't be sold to you. Why?
No, because people are hoarding.
Okay.
They buy the rice and keep it.
Okay.
Thinking that something's going to happen.
Okay.
Okay, that's not the case.
Okay.
Okay, and some of them do it with criminal intent.
Okay.
And we want to make sure that it doesn't happen.
Okay.
So we are here to several things. One, to show that there is consignment in the country. Two, to allow him to be able to serve whoever comes to his counter.
Okay.
Instead of only his customer, which is understandable.
Okay.
And they have agreed to do it. And the third thing we're going to do out, we'll have evidence of people who are selling rice above the stipulated price.
Okay.
And people will move on them.
Okay. So to clarify the doubt, what are some effective measures you guys are thinking about putting in place as for effectively today, all rice prices should go back to normal? What are some of the things you guys are going to do today?
We depend on the public.
Okay.
To let us know.
Okay.
We have pieces of evidence that have been given to us by consumers.
Okay.
We follow those. And you hear what will happen.
Okay.
You stay with us.
All right.
And the fact of the matter is, in the Ministry of Commerce,
okay,
will not permit anybody to try to undermine this economy.
Okay.
Rice is a very sensitive commodity.
Okay.
And those people that for which we have evidence that they are profiteering, we'll move against them.
Okay. So looking at the amount of rice, can you please tell my viewers and the Liberian people how many months the rice can be served for? Will I be no shortage and stuff like that? Because what I'm seeing is a lot of rice.
What we need to do is to talk to the general manager.
Okay.
What we have.
Okay, so hello.
I have the information we need to talk to.
Okay, so hello. Welcome to MCD TV Live. I want to know what the amount of rice what's in this place. How many months it can be served for?
Well, we bring in, like this month, two more ships is coming. One is arriving on Wednesday.
Okay.
And the other one
Okay, so the people outside that they were complaining about you now serving them the amount of the rice they want.
Yes.
So why?
Because all the tension is on us.
Okay.
So they are coming plenty. And we're not able to serve everybody at the same time. Now we make a certain quantity for each person, for everybody to get it.
Okay.
So I don't want to do it this way, so not few people can pick the rice and everybody will get a rice, and the price will be stable.
Oh, so these people that are outside, are there people buying for their homes or they are?
They're buying to sell.
Okay.
They are buying to sell.
Okay, so normally they come to the office. Do they normally come here to buy and carry to the store, or you guys carry to them?
We still supply up to now. They come from some of them. They carry the rice. Some of them we supply them.
Okay, so thank you.
Welcome.
Okay, thank you, bro.
You're welcome.
All right, so keep watching. We are making sure we get to the bottom of what's going on about the rice shortage. And as you can see, there are a lot of rice here. And we don't get it why people are saying there's no rice in the country. This is just one of the importer of rice, just one. So just imagine the others. And we have 5 importing rice companies within the country. And this is number one. And there are a lot of them. So we are going to another rest company called SWAT. So, so we are going to another rest company. This is just one of the rest companies we are going to. And we are trying to go to the next one. And yes, as you can see,
thank you.
working towards another rest company like there. There are five major rest companies within the country. And we just got through with the first one where we interviewed the minister. And now we are going to the second one, Cause One, as you can see in front of you. And to be able to make sure